Hi students, welcome to Banik Smart Class Forum. This is Vikas sir, the faculty of Banik Computer Academy. Today we will discuss about the computer application paper which is related to relevant competitive examination, specifically banking and SSE. So what is the defined syllabus, and in this syllabus how many chapters are there, how many number of questions will be there in the examination, basically in banking as well as in SSE also. So details we will discuss, as well as one chapter we will discuss today. So let's have a look and let's go. Okay students, see here, see the smart screen. Here we will discuss what is the exact syllabus which is related to our competitive examination, both banking and SSE. So in this screen, see here, this is the PDF, and here I am mentioning the topic which is related to our computer applications theory part. So see here how many chapters are there. So it is started from chapter number 1 to chapter number 15. So what are the topics are there? See here, chapter number 1, this is fundamental of computer and IT. Chapter number 2, history and generations. Chapter number 3, input and output device. Chapter number 4, hardware software and its types of softwares. Chapter number 5, memory and its measuring unit. Chapter number 6, internet communication technology. Chapter number 7, which is related to Microsoft Office package. One is Word, second is Excel, third is PowerPoint. And chapter number 10 is Microsoft Windows. Chapter number 11, important full form and computer terminology. Chapter number 12, fundamental of database. Chapter number 13, introduction to cyber crime. Some relevant concept terms are there, we will discuss. Chapter number 14, program language, the basic idea about the program language. And last chapter is computer aptitude. So total is 15 chapters. So I am mentioning here 15 chapter. And see here on the top, here the marks is 50. That means it does not mean that in all the exam the mark is 50. No, different examination, different mark is there. Like in ASO exam, theory part is 50 marks. But if you think about some SSE exam, basically Odisha SSE examination. So in Odisha SSE, junior assistant, junior clerk, senior assistant, senior clerk, here theory mark is 100. And if you think about, if you discuss about the banking examination, specifically in RRB, regional rural bank, in RRB PO main, RRB clerk main, here 40 question is there in computer application theory part. As well as if you think about in IBPS PO main, IBPS clerk main, SBI PO main, SBI clerk main, here 10 to 15 question is there, but related to the computer aptitude. So it is a new concept which is related to our computer theory part. So we will discuss also all the chapters one by one as per our lessons. And another part is the computer skill test practical part. Now it is associated in almost all the examinations, basically in SSE, in OPSC examination also, whether may be officer exam as well as whether may be assistant examination. Now in CGL command graduate level, CHSL, then Odisha SSE junior clerk, OPSC junior assistant. So almost if you think about the SSE model exam, the practical skill test part is there, and almost the mark is 50 marks, and these are the model Word, Excel, PowerPoint, Windows and Access. So about this concept, I have already taken one lessons on the previous video. So you can ask this previous video also. So details also we will go for one by one as per our model. Okay. So today we will go for our the first chapter, which is related to the fundamental of computer and IT. So what is the chapter? What is the syllabus is mentioned in this chapter, and what are the relevant questions may come in the examinations. So we will go. Okay. So let's have a look about our chapter, fundamental of computer and information technology. Okay. So let's go. Okay, students, see the smart screen, and we will discuss today the chapter 1 of our computer application theory part, which is related to our banking and SSE exam. So what is the chapter? The chapter is fundamental of computer and information technology. So what is the defined syllabus? See here, it has defined what is computer, its characteristics, its applications, components, component of CPU, as well as the type of computer, like mini computer, micro computer, mainframe, as well as supercomputer. So this is the defined content which is related to our chapter fundamental of computer and IT. So first we will start about the first concept, meaning of computer. So what does it mean, computer? So first we have to know about that exactly, what is the concept behind that, why it is so named computer exactly. So as per the history of the computer system, The computer term was derived from the Latin term computore. So, see the smart screen here. So, I am mentioning computer is the term which is derived from the Latin term computore, which means to calculate or to count, to sum up or to think together. That means the computer history tells that it derived from the Latin term computore, which means to compute or to calculate. In a single line, one can say the word computer means a device that performs the computations. Clear? So, another concept is, what is the term behind that? Computer. So, in some website, in some different book also, it has mentioned its full form. But if any interview or anyone if asks you what is the full form of computer, then simply you can say, based upon the computer history, it derived from the Latin term computere, which means to compute or to calculate. But in a simple way, we can say in another full form, but it not justified. We can say it is a full form which has derived, but we cannot say it is a justified full form. So, computer, common operating machine, particular used for technical, educational as well as research also. So, this is the terms, but we can say this is a completely full form of computer, but the history tells that it derived from the Latin term computere, which means to compute. But another way we can say in a full form, common operating machine, particular used for technical, educational as well as research also. Okay. So, what is the definition of the computer? We have to discuss also here. So, if you define the term computer, so simply we can say the electronic device that takes the data as an input, processes it through the processor, and after processing it produces the result as an output. So, here also I am mentioning the computer is an electronic machine or device that accept the data as an input, process it, and after processing give the result as an output. That means, simply we can say the three basic operation, input, processing as well as output. So, here also I am mentioning here the four tasks, relevant tasks which is related to our computer system. One is accept the data as an input, and so many devices which are associated with our computer system known as input devices. Through the input devices, the data has input to the computer system. So, what are the input devices? What is the concept? We will go for the details in chapter number 2, because we are mentioning here different chapters. Second is operate the data according to the particular rules, means we can say the processing operations, and here the processing device is CPU, central processing unit. This is the brain of the computer system. We can say the heart of the computer system. We can say the central part of the computer system. We can say the core component of the computer system through which the computer system can perform the manipulation operation, or we can say the processing operation. And third part is generate the result, which is known as the output. So, many output devices are associated with the computer system to produce the output result, like monitor, printer. Okay. And fourth is to save the result. That means, to keep the output result, we need the storage operation. So, fourth operation which is related to our computer system known as storage. So, and the device is known as storage device. So, if you think about that, the four basic operation of the computer system, one is input, then process, then output, then storage. And this was the question which was asked in RRB, Regional Rural Bank, PO examination in 2011-12. So, the question was that choose the proper sequence based upon the operation of the computer system. So, the proper sequence is the input, then process, then output, and fourth is storage. Then go for the characteristics of the computer system. So, what is the characteristics of the computer system? So, see here, I have mentioned here the five important characteristics of the computer system. One is speed, second is accuracy, third is reliability, fourth is versatility, and fifth is storage capacity. So, based upon the characteristics, in some relevant interview examination, basically in banking also, banking interview examinations, based upon your computer knowledge, the interviewer also may be asks you the question, what is the basic difference between computer and calculator? Maybe they will ask, already they have asked to our students who have attended the examination interview in PO exam. So, if they have asked the difference between the computer and calculator, then at least you can give the 2 to 3 basic points of the distinguish between computer and calculator. So first point, you can say the computer can perform both arithmetic as well as logical operations, but if you think about the calculator, it is designed only to perform some numerical operation. This is the first distinguish. Second distinguish is we can store large volume of data permanently for a long period of time in computer system, as it has support storage capacity, but calculator, it does not have any storage capacity to store large volume of data permanently. And third concept is versatility. The important term is versatility, means it derived from the word versatile. We are telling that Amitabh Bachchan, Big B in Bollywood industry is a versatile actor, means the actor can perform multiple role effectively, efficiently. Like that, in computer system also versatility defines that multiple types of function, multiple types of work can perform simultaneously, parallelly in the computer system. But in case of calculator, it support only one operations, mathematical operations at a time. So these are the three basic relevant distinguish between computer and calculator. One is it support both arithmetic and logical operation, but calculator does not. Second is computer has the large storage capacity to store large volume of data, but calculator does not support. And third thing is that the versatility, it is possible in case of computer system, but if you think about calculator, it does not. So this is the basic difference between computer and calculator. So see here the characteristics. One is speed. The computer is an electronic device which has a very high speed operational functionality. That means from the human being, the effort of the human being, the computer system can do more effective through the fast operations based upon the technology. So I am mentioning here about 3 to 4 million arithmetic operation per second the computer can system can do, but it is not possible in case of simple human being can do this much amount of data, this much amount of work in a single time or in a per second. And second is accuracy. Accuracy is the term which exactly defines the extraness of the result. The computer never gives any wrong information until the user deliver the instruction which is not matched to the computer system. So if any type of operation which is performed by the computer system, then it produces the result very accurately and give the accuracy about the output which we have expect from the computer system. Third thing is that reliability. The another important term is reliability, exactly. So what is the concept behind that? The computer perform the respective part of the work without making any mistake and without getting tired. Human being can do the wrong work, human being can produce the wrong output, but if the input of the data is correct, if the input of the programming part is correct, then computer provide the exact output which is 100% accurate also. So this is reliability. And fourth is versatility. Recently we have discussed, means multiple types of function, multiple types of work can perform by the computer system at a time, and variety of jobs, this is also mentioning, okay. And fifth is storage capacity. Here also we have already discussed, the computer system can store and recall large volume of data permanently for a long period of time until the user delete the data. It store the data, knowledge, result for a long period of time, which is not possible for the human mind, because human brain forget 90% of the storage periodically based upon the age has increased. So these are the five important characteristics. So I'm repeating again, one is speed, second is accuracy, third is reliability, fourth is versatility, and fifth is storage capacity, okay. So based upon our discussion model, another part is there which is also the MCQ. I will also discuss today which are the relevant MCQ which is discussed related to our discussion today, okay. Then go for the next part, the applications, means another important part is application. So if the computer system has designed, then where it is implementing now? So if we think about every field now in the real world, every field from field number 1 to field number n, all part now they are associated with the computer system. So among these, I'm deriving 10 most environment where the computer is implemented. So see here, one is business, second is education, third is marketing, fourth is banking sector, fifth is insurance sector, sixth is communications, seventh is healthcare, eighth is military, ninth is engineering design, and 10th is scientific research. So these are the 10 important platform or base or area, or we can say the field where the computer system has implemented, and through this computer system the relevant task or work is carried on. So little bit description also I'm mentioning here. So one is business. So in business, the biggest concept is the computer is used in business organizations, and see here I'm mentioning here basically the payroll calculations, the sales analysis, budgeting, financial forecasting, managing the employee database, and maintaining the stock also. So these are the relevant work basically which is related to the MSME sector, which is related to the MNC also, which is related to small business entrepreneurs also. So these are the basically important part, like payroll system, sales analysis, budgeting, financial forecasting, managing the employee data. Okay, and second go for the educations. Now due to the COVID-19 effect, so almost all the school and education now completely off. So through NCERT also, through Odisha government also, in basically in UGC also, basically in different university also, they are now starting the e-classes system, video recording classes system, live classes system, and it is possible only through the help of computer system. So now in education also I'm mentioning, even the distance learning, means we can say the e-learning system. So Vanik also now started the e-learning system, distance learning system. So they are providing the live and video lessons, which is relevant to our different course. Through these video lessons, the students can view this video and can take the knowledge about the relevant topic. Okay, and third is marketing. So specifically now we are telling that in marketing it is known as digital marketing, and in digital marketing the one is the biggest thing is that the advertisements. So in advertisements basically creating the advertisement, now it is creating by the professionals through the graphics and art, and based upon the graphics and art it has now telecasting in different TV channels also. Okay, and another is the home shopping, means online shopping. Now different websites, they are channelized for online shopping and home shopping. Through the mobile app also now we are purchasing every goods and services through these services. So this is the concept about the marketing part. And third is banking industry. So almost all the functionality of the banks now done through computer system. Now in all the banking sector, if you think about the regional rural bank, if you think about the nationalized bank, if you think about Reserve Bank of India, if you think about any private sector bank as well as any foreign bank also. So almost all the banking sector, they are doing their work effectively, efficiently, and providing the large volume of information which is related to our deposit, withdraw, fund transfer, as well as ATM, all the things. So I'm mentioning here also the current balance sheet, deposit, overdraft, interest charge, share, records, ATM machines, and relevant to our all the things. Now banking sector also providing the all the services through computer system. Similarly the insurance sector also, they are providing the relevant informations. And next is the communications. So the biggest part of the communications, we can say the verbal or non-verbal communication, now computer technology is associated. So see here, the idea or the picture or speech that is received and understood clearly, correctly by the person for whom it is meant for. Exactly. So now in communications, if you think about basically the non-verbal communications, the relevant computer technology associated, like chatting, email, Usenet, FTP, video conferencing, and different social media app we are using, like WhatsApp, Instagram, Twitter also, we are using the best communications computer technology through which we can interact with our people worldwide. So next is the medical sector, we can say the healthcare system also. Now all the important diagnosis or dialysis, we are telling that the radio analysis, exactly, it is completely done through the computer system, powerful computer system. So I'm mentioning here, various types of miraculous therapy, ECG scanning, different type of scanning also, CT scanning we are telling, ultrasound exactly. So different types of radio therapy now done through the computer systems. And next is the defense and military also, not only the military, in all the defense sector exactly, in airlines, air force also, in naval system also, as well as in military system also. The weapons, basically the tools which helps for developing the missile, as well as computer builds the links between the soldiers and the commander through the satellite system, construction of the weapons, controlling their functionality through radar system. Now the latest technological weapons are also associated of the computer system for the defense, and now the defense system also, they are doing the work completely through computer system. And next is the engineering design also, basically in, we can say in construction work, basically see here, designing the buildings, magazines, prints, newspaper, books, that means in publication also, as well as in designing also, basically in real estate, the construction, the different construction of the buildings also, as well as in publication work also, now it is done through computer systems. And last term is, the point number 10 is scientific research, exactly. So now the scientific research, I'm mentioning some example like weather forecasting, nuclear fusion, nuclear fission, molecular modeling, quantum physics. So all scientific research work also now done through computer system, because without computer we can do this type of work like molecular modeling, weather forecasting, nuclear fusion. Not only the computer system, but we can say the powerful computer system, super computer system with high speed advanced processor with memories also, it is done. And now we are getting the accuracy result also, regarding our weather also, because every year different cyclone also, they are coming to our environment. So at least 3 to 4 days before or 5 days before, the accurate information we are getting to the weather forecasting system, which is very helpful to save our people, to save our nation also. So these are the 10 points which is related to our applications of different sectors. So what are the terms? Again, I'm telling to you, business, education, marketing, banking, insurance, communications, healthcare, military, engineering design, as well as scientific research also, okay. Then go for the next part. The next part is, what is CPU? What are the component of CPU and what is the functionality of CPU, okay. CPU, the full form is central processing unit. So remember, the CPU is basically known as the brain of the computer system. We can say the core component of the computer system. We can say the central part of the computer system, and this is the unit which is perform the processing work which has taken by the input device, and after processing it produce the result which has display on the output screen. So I'm mentioning also here, the CPU is considered as the brain of the computer, and it perform all types of processing operations. Remember, whether may be arithmetic operation, as well as whether may be logical operations. Then go for, so this is small image of CPU processor, we can say, which is present in the motherboard in our computer system, okay. So then go for, what is the component of CPU basically? So remember, as CPU perform the processing operations, so based upon the processing operations, CPU has three vital component. One is ALU, second is CU, and third is MU. ALU, arithmetic logic unit, second is CU, control unit, and third is memory unit. Memory unit means the register. So what is the concept behind that? ALU, arithmetic logic unit. So simply remember, ALU, arithmetic logic unit, means the unit which is perform the arithmetic operation as well as logical operation. So remember, in our computer system, all the arithmetic operation as well as the logical operation which is done are performed through the ALU associated to CPU. Then second is the control unit, okay. After ALU, second is CU, control unit. So what is the function of control unit? Control unit, combination of two word, one is control and another is unit. That means the unit which is used to control all of our operation which is performed by arithmetic logic unit inside the CPU. So see here, I'm also mentioning here, the function of the control unit is to make the sure that ALU, memory unit and input output devices, all are must be in a particular logical order, and to control the entire operation of the CPU it is designed. That's why it is so named what? Control unit. That means the arithmetic logic unit, memory unit and all the input and output devices. So there is a sequence of order for performing the logical operations. So this logical order and the controlling of the entire operation, it is done by the unit which is known as control unit. And third term is memory unit. So inside the memory unit, I mention here register. Actually it is register, but why it is treated as memory unit? Because in our computer system the CPU is there, and in CPU not only one register is present, but also so many registers are associated, like program counter, stack pointer, memory address register, memory buffer register, flag register, instruction register. So all registers are work in a unitly and perform the operation of the storage. That's why it is known as memory unit. So what is the function of this register exactly? So remember, at the time of processing operations, before producing the final result by the CPU, the intermediate result and data must be kept inside a memory, and this intermediate data or instruction keep inside the memory, and this is known as register. So one is ALU, second is CU, and third is memory unit or register. These are the three important component of the CPU through which the CPU perform the processing operations. And based upon these processing operations, the CPU has four basic operations. So remember, if question is that the instruction cycle or CPU cycle can carry out in how many number of steps? So these are four steps. One is fetch cycle, second is decode cycle, third is execution cycle, and fourth is write back cycle. This is the question which have already comes more than 20 times in different examinations. So if question is that the instruction cycle has four phases, so what are the four phases? One is fetch cycle, second is decode, third is execution, and fourth is write back cycle. So what does it mean, fetch cycle? So first we have to know what is the meaning of fetch. Fetch means to retry, to access. So what to fetch, what to retry basically? So while the user providing the data or instruction through the input devices, the data are basically stored in a waiting memory, waiting hall. This memory is known as RAM, random access memory. RAM is known as a waiting memory which keep all the incoming data before handover to the CPU. So in this fetch cycle, the data which are present inside the RAM are fetched, means retrieved to CPU to perform the processing operation. That means this is the first phase in which the data or instruction which can be fetched from the RAM and handover to CPU for processing operation. That's why I am mentioning here obtaining the program instruction or data item from the memory RAM. Second is decode cycle. So what does it mean, decode cycle here? The decode cycle tells that as computer system only understand binary 0 and 1, so whatever we are providing the data or instruction, it is not directly in binary form, basically we are providing in our readable form. So those data which are providing to the computer system, this data must be converted into binary form, 0 and 1 form, so that the CPU can understand the instruction and can start the processing operation. That's why after fetching the data from the RAM, then this fetch data are converted into computer understandable code, means binary code. So this is the second phase in which the data or instruction translated into the computer understandable form, which is known as binary form. And third is execution cycle. This is the actual phase in which the data or instruction are processing by the CPU. So first phase is fetch cycle, in which the data bring or fetch from RAM to CPU. Second is it has decoded, means in the converted to the binary form. And in the third phase, the actual processing operation is started by ALU. If it is arithmetic operation, then responsible is ALU. If it is logical operation, also responsible is ALU. And last term is write back cycle, means after completion of the processing operation, the output result has produced. And this output result, if it is necessary for the further use, then this must be kept in a memory location, so that whenever it is needed we can back, that means we can access the data, that's why it is known as write back. Here in computer science term, write means store and back means access retrieve. So whatever the output result we have stored in the memory, we can back means access whenever it is necessary. So these are the four important term, one is phase, decode, execution and write back. So these are the four phases of four basic operation of the CPU cycle. And the last term I am mentioning here, the speed of CPU. So in our personal computer we are using the processor, microprocessor. So the speed at which the CPU perform the basic operation, it is known as clock rate, means technically in computer science term it is known as clock rate. And to measure the clock rate, the unit which is used is known as horse, the horsepower, HERTZ, horse. And now the latest unit we are using to measure the speed of CPU, it is gigahertz. So that's why in every personal computer system, whether maybe desktop or laptop, if we check the properties of our computer system, we can basically see in our processor, if it is processor i3 7th generation, 8th generation, and inside the bracket it must be mentioned like 2.4 gigahertz processor, 2.6 gigahertz processor, means this is the speed capacity of the processor through which the CPU can perform its processing operations. So this is the concept also I am mentioning here, HZ, hertz and megahertz, gigahertz. Okay. So various types of processor like Intel Pentium, AMD processor, as well as we are using now the latest processor like Intel I series processor, i3, i5, i7, different generation is there. So its unit is clock rate, and to measure the clock rate, the speed, it is calculated by gigahertz. So for the today lessons, this is the concept which is related to our fundamental of computer and information technology. So in this topic we have discussed related to what is computer, what is the full form of computer, then how many components are there, then what is the characteristics of computer system, we have already discussed what is the characteristics of the computer system, then we have discussed the application of the computer system, 10 application, important application we have discussed, and another part is we have discussed what is CPU, what are the component of CPU like ALU, major memory unit and control unit, then four phases of CPU cycle, phase, decode, execution, write back, and latest is the speed of the CPU. So overall we have completed our chapter 1, fundamental of computer and information technology. So based upon this fundamental, I have designed some valuable questions which have already come in different examination. So let's go about the MCQ. We will discuss about the relevant MCQ which is related to our today chapter discussion. Okay, let's go.